It's now time for our second standalone speaking session on role of out of home in telling brand stories. And our speaker is Mr. Peeyush Bachlaus, Head of Marketing, Kansai Nerolac Paints Limited. Spanning 17 years of consumer marketing experience enriched across sectors, FMCG, automobiles, telecom, and single brand retail brand startup, P&L impacting roles delivering exponential growth on brands, addressing diverse target audiences, including youth, that is preteens and teens, families, working professionals, and farming communities across urban and rural geographies, a proud member of teams credited with brand and product launches, new market creation, and winnings at Guinness World Records, Abbey's, and WOW Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together to welcome Mr. Peeyush Bachlaus. Before that, I have a small announcement actually. There is a car, I'm just naming it, it's DL3CB8241. I request you to please get in touch with the valet. Thank you. I'm repeating, DL3CB8241. Thank you.
It's on. Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for that introduction. I don't know how many people you met, and you must have gone and met most of my bosses, and I hope they had good things to speak about me, which you captured. So just to give you a background, I represent a paint company. So we are in the business of, technically speaking, in the business of coatings for surfaces, which we popularly refer to as paints, and it's a lot about colors. Now this is that part of a talk where you can, you know, blatantly do brand plugins. So just bear with me for that. But what are the surfaces that we coat? We do jewelries, we do furniture, we do white goods, we are enjoying a lion's share in the automobile coating sector, industrial coatings, and of course we do coat homes, interiors and exteriors. Now this is an artist's representation of all the surfaces that Nerolac coats, and it's an installation that we had put up some time back in Mumbai as part of one of the festivals that we had partnered, and I thought that it was a very interesting piece to pull out and create a context with. While yes, it does reflect that there is a bit of Nerolac in our lives, in our homes, but it also brings me to the topic which is about out of home and how out of home can help build the brand stories. There was a very interesting panel discussion as I walked in, and it was on, and you know, there was a lot of conversation around the future and the possibilities, and I was so happy to hear that a lot of people are talking about the challenges, because that's probably a very important thing to note and be cognizant of when we are embarking on big ambitious journeys. But having said that, from a marketing point of view, from a brand perspective, person who's handling a brand, I thought that while there is a lot of messaging around content, there is a lot of messaging around what's possible, what's not possible, let's see if from a brand's perspective, what can be spoken about. I'll just bore you with four slides with humongous amount of data. Technically, what I'm talking about is that the future, there is a lot of proliferation of out of home that we all are talking about. There is a lot of new media which is opening up and everybody is lapping it up. In India, we are told that the FICCI report, recent report, tells us the CAGR, which is so positive. I'm so happy to put it up because most of the businesses that are going to drive this, I am not partnering them. So most of the seeking calls might get diverted elsewhere. But having said that, the idea is that when there is growth, then obviously there is a lot of potential to even improvise. And that's something which excites me personally and excites us as a brand. There was a lot of discussion about the digital billboards and you know, the whole geo-tagging or geo-fencing and then Wi-Fi enablement. All of that is brilliant. And that's what technology is probably going to allow us to achieve in the near future. But from my perspective, what I see is that there are tech-led media opportunities, which means that the messages need to be crafted to keep that in mind and to suit these opportunities which are coming in. So from a, again, from a brand point of view, for a marketer, it again throws back a challenge at us in terms of being able to understand this medium and these opportunities and be able to tailor make our content accordingly. So there is this whole give and take, there is a, this whole symbiosis that needs to happen at both ends. And trust me, when we meet, we get to meet some of you who come down for different interactions, pitches, or for that matter, you know, when we are trying to crack a new opportunity or a new idea that is being built, we actually learn a lot. And the learning actually happens because you and your teams are able to bring to us these solutions which are potentially, you know, going to amplify our message. But out of home, from our perspective, we always, we do believe that outdoors was in the past. Most of our careers probably started when outdoors was the only OOH. Today, there was mentioned that there are seven. Basically, anything which is outside the door is out of home, which could mean, you know, sticking my neck out, but which could also mean anything that you do in a village but gets seen anywhere else is out of home, right? So that's a broad, I would say, a definition that one keeps in mind. TV remains the big daddy, as one of the panelists mentioned. But what interests me is that the growing reach of out of home and the growing reach of internet and smartphones. There was a very interesting anecdote which was shared about, you know, people are waiting for the red light. And that's so true. But the fact of the matter remains that these two mediums, out of home and data, are talking. And they are talking how? That's something which is really exciting, because these two mediums put together are actually putting to, actually providing a potent weapon in the hands of all marketeers to actually engage and embrace audiences. That's something, again, which is exciting us a lot going forward. Okay, there was a lot of noise in the past, and there was a lot of mention which is happening around the potential of DOH. There is a lot of, as I say, a lot of projections in terms of numbers, etc. There's a lot of money to be made, I understand. And all of us are into it. The point is that how we will be able to take each of these innovations in our stride to really bring alive the brand messages that, that we continue to talk about. I spoke about our business, which is Colors. And Colors is something which is visible. Behind Colors, there's a lot of technology that we also employ and we also kind of do. But the core remains, when it comes to consumer interactions, it's a lot about colors and a lot about what is happening aesthetically, what is happening to the visual appeal of the surfaces or the surroundings. So there is a lot of transformation from that sense, which happens when you apply a coat of paint somewhere. While all of this is happening, parallelly, the brand narratives, so to speak of, have moved from being preachy to being conversational. There's a lot of conversation that is happening. And this conversation is actually bedrocked on the need for information. There is a lot of information being sought, there is a lot of information which is being offered, which is floating around. Practically everybody is into conversations. But when the information is sought, information gets, there is active searches that are happening, people are talking at forums. For example, this is one of a very rich forum where we are exchanging thoughts and ideas. There are interactions happening, but there are forced as well, platforms that force information onto us, TV, banners, all those, where it's a one-way communication. The takeaway from consumers is that it is static, it is a hard sell in a lot of cases, there's a lot of clutter, and in a lot of sense, it tests their patience. Now, when we are talking about information, which is driving conversations, but there is an aspect of information which is a lot still in the space of being forced, there is an opportunity to drive conversations which basically are participative. It could spawn from a visual impact created, it could be immersive. And here, basically we believe that OOH, or out of home, has a role to play in a very big way. Let's just look at one or two examples that have been catching our eyes. If I say participative, it's basically action, outcome is shared. There is a very interesting video which I would like to share with you, and then we can talk about it.
Survival billboard.
Pretty nervous.
I'm ready.
The pain is only temporary. Glory lasts forever.
You have the power. You can vote in survivalbillboard.com. And you voted for snow. This is the start of the true endurance test.
I'm getting so angry at this race.
It's sadistic, but I like it.
Let us know what you're thinking. Keep chatting to us on Twitch.
Suffering from genuine fatigue at this point.
I underestimated the challenge. That's it. I'm done.
Goodness knows how they're managing it.
I'm gonna call it quits here.
They have been up there for an incredible amount of time. Our contestants have been through the elements.
What caught my eye was the 8 seconds dwell time versus the 8 minute dwell time, just because of the sheer impact of the activity that was happening. And I again am cognizant of the fact the challenges that all the panelists talked about that we in India face. It's not lost on us, but let's stay inspired by looking at this stuff as well. That's the point. We also tried something similar in the past, and this was in a remote village, and again, if I go back to the previous video, previous activity, the cost impact was actually in the long term when you look at the way Xbox and the Tomb Raider actually raked it in. You know, it was well worth it. I'll just play this video and then I'll just share a point of view on that as well. Thank you.
सरहेटा राजस्थान के पिछड़े हुए गांव में से एक। अस्वच्छता और अशिक्षा यहाँ की सबसे बड़ी समस्या है।
When we came to Sarheta village the first time, it was among the backward villages of Rajasthan.
गलियां जो गंदी हैं, उसको साफ करनी है, नालियां साफ करनी है।
जहां रोजमर्रा की जिंदगी तकलीफों से भरपूर और बेरंग हो, उसमें अगर रंग भर दिए जाएं, तो शायद इन अंधेरों में रोशनी का काम करे। नेरोलैक और नीम राणा ग्रुप की एक कोशिश सरहेटा को एक नया रूप देने की।
Like when we were kids, we used to get pots of paint and we used to splash and have fun. They are having that kind of experience which they've never had before.
बढ़िया चल रहा है।
गांव के लोगों के चेहरों पर एक अलग सी आभा सी नजर आ रही है। जिस तरह से उनके घर रंग बिरंगे हो गए, निसंदेह एक मील का पत्थर साबित होगा।
हजारों उम्मीदें, एक ही मकसद, सरहेटा को स्वच्छ, सुंदर और खुशहाल बनाने का।
दिवाली जैसा माहौल लग रहा है कि जगह जगह अच्छी सफाई हो रही है, अच्छा पेंट हो रहा है।
एक जन आंदोलन, एक प्रण, सबको साथ लेके बदलाव लाने का।
हमने इसी गांव के ही यूथ को लेकर के पूरा का पूरा ये कलर किया है।
गांव में कलर होगा तो हमारे गांव में टूरिस्ट बढ़ेंगे, लोगों को रोजगार भी मिलेगा।
रंग करके पूरे स्कूल अच्छा लगता है।
खुशी आएगी, बहुत ज्यादा खुशी आएगी।
The entire village is like a festive kind of a atmosphere is out there. सब ऐसा enjoy कर रहे हैं, they want कि हाँ यार कुछ हो रहा है हमारे गांव में।
Nerolac ने specially जो paint use किया है, वो health point of view से बहुत ही safe है।
You know when you have beautiful walls, you don't want to put kachra in front of them.
पहला ऐसा गांव होगा जो colorful होगा।
एक चिंगारी सी सुलग गई है, लहर की तरह पूरे देश में छा सकती है।
सात दिन, 850 से ज्यादा घर, दो स्कूल और अनगिनत मुस्कुराहटें। बदलती जिंदगियां, बदलता देश।
Just underscores a point in my mind about कहानी कहीं से भी बन सकती है, उसको कैसे आगे लेके जाना है कोई एक तरीका निकाल सकते हैं। Not necessarily everything will happen in our on the main roads in our beautiful metros, but I mean we did this and I think it's got a lot of millions of views and it's reached a lot. That's where, you know, basically the out of home is kind of met for us from our context. It has met and you know met with digital and kind of become slightly bigger. Hi. The other piece is the visual impact. I am sure all of us know this, right? This has captured everybody's imagination. I think earned marketing is about $7.5 million. Within the first 12 hours of release, it had got some billion impressions on Twitter, some 250,000 shares on Instagram or some, I mean, crazy numbers. And it's just one single piece that has been put out there. So the power of that idea, I think, is much more important even in today's world. Very happy and glad on behalf of all my fellow marketeers to welcome each and every agency partner to come and have a chat with us about what are the ideas we want to put out there. Digital, technology, formats, important, very important. But I think the underlying story really needs to get captured, and then of course all of us are together in it. So that's about visual impact. Another visual impact which we tried again as an installation there in Bombay, and it's got views, it's got reach, but the best thing about it is that it was all done in a very eco-friendly way, which is what our brand's call out is, and we were able to actually engage people and audience on that platform. As a result, in fact, while there was a visual impact here, but there was a lot of participation, we ended up having about a 1,600 feet long canvas on which the city of Mumbai, the Mumbai cars came and painted their vision of a beautiful Mumbai. I wish I had a picture, but I'm afraid I'm not able to get that. But it's a beautiful sight, and we've been able to get people to come and contribute to creating something which was out of home and talk about it. When it comes to visual impact, we did something last year. We started it at Mumbai Airport, whereby we took up one of the belts. And again, going back to our core area, which is to color all of your lives, colors and then hence shade cards are very critical for all paint organizations and paint companies. So we thought that there was this medium available, and if there is a way of bringing alive our shades proposition through this medium, will it be possible? Of course, it took us about good 6 to 8 months of R&D with the agency and the site owners. But at the end of the day, the impact was really nice, and yes, it did get talked about a lot. So it was well worth the time and money spent. We come to immersive. So, in fact, the airport activity which we did, let me just play a small clip for you, and maybe it'll just help establish that immersion that I'm talking about. Yeah, can I have the video?
A surprise plan to make Diwali, the festival of lights, even brighter for those who are yet to reach home.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we will be landing soon in Mumbai. Your luggage will be available on the new colorful belt number 3. We wish you a very happy and a Ronak Bhari Diwali, and thank you for flying with Indigo.
बैगेज बेल्ट की तरफ गया तो देखा तो हर तरफ ब्लैक बैंड लगे होते तो लेकिन एक ही तरफ कलरफुल बेल्ट था मैं देखा तो अपना दिल्ली वाला बेल्ट था ध्यान से देखा तो सब नेरोलैक पेंट का डिफरेंट कलर्स का था उसमें मेरे नाम का गिफ्ट था तो मैंने ले लिया और बाकी पैसेंजर्स को भी मिला और वो भी बहुत खुश थे
अच्छा लग रहा है ये मेरी पहली फ्लाइट थी और पहला सरप्राइज गिफ्ट मिला है बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है
इट्स अ प्लेजेंट सरप्राइज दैट नेरोलैक वुड थिंक ऑफ दिस इट्स अ वेरी यूनिक वे ऑफ वेलकमिंग पीपल
आई रियली वाज फीलिंग अ लिटिल सैड कि दिवाली के दिन आई एम ट्रैवलिंग दिस इज द बेस्ट सरप्राइज दैट आई हैव गॉट सो फार आई रियली वुड लाइक टू थैंक नेरोलैक फॉर दिस एक्सपीरियंस
This is the first time I'm getting this out of the world experience. If anybody can connect, it's Nerolac. You have really painted the picture of my life. And today you have made my day. I wish you and your entire team a very, very happy Diwali.
It is such a wonderful gesture. I'm surprised to have it here on the airport.
This is very new to us. We thought that somebody is personally there taking. But all on a sudden, actually, everybody is taking it. When Madam told me, "Dekho, dekho, dam hai." I don't see that my name is here.
I always thought that Holi is colorful, but thanks to Nerolac, this Diwali has been very colorful.
May every homecoming be joyous. Nerolac Paints wishes you a very happy and safe Diwali.
So, while yes, we had put up the colors and we had put it out, and this wasn't a brand plug. Genuinely, I felt that this is worth sharing. But the idea was that immersion of into that moment and catching that moment. I myself was surprised to see the kind of expressions we captured candid from all those passengers. That kind of felt nice, as well as it kind of gave us that confidence that what were we actually giving away? We were giving away Diwali sweets, diyas, and we gave a plant. But I think that whole surprise element married with that color proposition, I think worked. And that's another example which I thought would be interesting to share. I'm told that I'm now overrunning time, so I would skip the last video that I have. So I'll just quickly wrap up. Basically, the idea is that the out of home is a very brilliant platform which can help brands create a bridge with consumers to sense, to listen, to seek experiences that are immersive, that are participative. Basically, what we are talking about is coming together and creating some exciting conversation stories. Thanks.
Thank you so much for enlightening us with your words, sir. And on that note, we'll move on to the second panel discussion for the evening. The topic is creating. All right, sir, I request you to please stay back on stage as I request a token of appreciation. I now invite Mr. Gautam Bhirani, founder and CEO of Bar Talk India, to give away the memento. Have a huge round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen.